Hello everybody, Dr. Carlo Oyer here with the YouTube channel The ED Exit Video. This actually was a user upload. They used my iPad application to upload a video directly to my channel. And at first, you know, you wonder, well, what do they upload this for? But I think we can get some medical education out of it. So let's watch it together. Let's play it here.
Oh!
And he does a slow motion, which I tend to do in my videos too, and there's something impressive. And he's walking off, looking for bleeding. So obviously a very athletic gentleman. Look at that, good job. So even though does not seem like a purely medical video, certainly some things we can talk about here and about closed head injuries. And let's talk about the ER management, because that way I can really talk about what I do. If you want to read more about concussions and contusions and things like that, there's specific videos for that. But let's talk about if you were this patient, if you were this person who just sustained a pretty significant blow to the head, when do you really need to be evaluated by a physician? Well, the reasons that you would need to be evaluated would be kind of the same reasons the doctor would consider to do more. Any kind of loss of conscience, whether it be 2 seconds or 1 minute, any definitive loss of conscience would be a higher predictor for a worse illness or worse disease, so we would want to see you in the ER for that. Any neurological findings, so persistent nausea and vomiting, anything more than 2 or 3 vomits, you definitely want to be evaluated. Numbness, tingling, weakness of the arm. If the headache seems out of proportion to what it should be, obviously you just hit your head. But if you're just hurting out here where you got hit, then that's one thing. But if you're hurting inside and it's severe and it's affecting your function, you should definitely be evaluated. Obviously, if you're in any kind of blood thinner, aspirin, Coumadin, Pradaxa, Lovenox, or anything like that, I don't think if you'd be in blood thinners, you'd be doing this kind of stuff. But those patients are high predictors. Obviously, they're very young. Kids less than 5 years old with a head injury, or old people. And by old, sadly enough, we mean anybody over age 65, as the brain starts shrinking with age, the bridging veins lengthen, and then any kind of even minor trauma can result in shearing or tearing of those veins, and then consider a bleed. Now, if this is a patient, he didn't have loss of consciousness, he didn't have any focal neural emphysis, he's not nauseous or vomiting, but he had a big, significant head injury from the fall, and you can see it right, you know, when he goes down and hits it. Is that you should let somebody know that you have this head injury. That way, if your mentation changes, or if you're having, you know, that you're difficult to wear out, so you're acting weird, they know that you did have a head injury, because at that point you can't really tell them. And it'd be nice to know if you presented to the ER with a confusion state or acting weird, that we knew that you did in fact had a head injury. Now, just because you passed out and you wake up and you're fine, you shouldn't go to the ER. That's why we call that the lucid interval. If you passed out, you should definitely be evaluated. You could have something called an epidural hematoma, which is usually a smaller initially accumulation of blood between the dural space and the brain. And it looks like a little lens, a lenticular kind of blood accumulation. But epidural hematoma grow over time and eventually start putting pressure on the brain, and it can collapse through and herniate, which can be a very significant. A lot of people have died from epidural hematomas. Subdural hematomas, not as acute. It's more like a slow, gradual onset of neurological symptoms and things like that. So, this particular patient, my recommendation would be that if he doesn't have any symptoms neurological-wise in the next hour, he should tell his family about this head injury he had. That way he can be watched properly.